Imagine having a child who needed intensive care, not just for their first few years, but forever, even when, like Shane Chamberlain, you're middle-aged. Shane's mum, Diane, has cared for him almost constantly for half a century, meaning he can stay at home where he's happy and safe. But the Ministry of Health has regarded much of that as parenting rather than work, even though if Diane wasn't able to look after Shane, the taxpayer would pay for the totality of his care. Now, this has been highly controversial, with good reason. And at the beginning of last year, Diane Moody won an historic victory in the Court of Appeal against the Ministry of Health's decision to pay her only 17 hours a week at the minimum wage. That's 2.5 hours a day to look after a man completely incapable of looking after himself. And if Diane didn't do it, we would have to. Yesterday, the government announced the law under which this was happening was being changed, with one part being repealed entirely and a pay rise coming too. It's another in a series of victories for a remarkable group of New Zealand families after years of feeling taken for granted to the point of exploitation. But is it the end of the fight? Let's visit Diane Moody at the home where she cares for Shane, and with her is Jane Carrigan, who's worked tirelessly as an advocate for Diane and Shane and therefore for all the families in their situation. Good morning, you two. It's lovely to be with you on the North Shore. How are you both?
Oh, yeah,
well,
yeah.
We're great. Yeah, absolutely.
Brilliant, John. You've reached us at our peak.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
We peak at 7 in the morning, thank God.
Diane, can I...
We were up as early as the cameraman.
Good God. Well, we're delighted you're joining us. Diane, can I start with you? Where is Shane at the moment?
Sydney. Shane is sitting on the poof here in the lounge beside us, and taking it all in. After all, he is the employer. He likes to know what's going on.
Now, I don't think people understand this, so, Diane, will you explain it to them? Under the system as it currently functions, Shane, who is incapable of really doing anything for himself, is your employer, right?
Yes. Meant to be.
And how is he
Although
as an employer?
He doesn't do anything.
No, he doesn't. Well, he can't do anything, can he?
No, he can't do anything, no. He's, well, he's a great employer, really. He didn't do anything. He just, you know. But as far as the employment side goes, I really don't want to discuss that in detail. I think that employment side, because of the case that we've got coming up, needs to be discussed with... you know, my QC, Paul Dale, because that's sort of another, you know, sort of game altogether.
It's in the court at the moment.
Yes, you are. So, and Paul and Jane, I know Paul Dale is working on this case, and Jane, I know you've been working on it too. So
yes.
This is a case to dispute the absurdity of Shane, who has a mental age of roughly 3, being your employer, which is the current setup. Jane, can I come to you as a legal advocate and as somebody who's worked so tirelessly for this family and therefore for others? What's your response to what was announced yesterday?
Can I just say I'm not a legal advocate?
Well, you've done a lot of background work for these court cases, right? And you've been a passionate advocate for these families.
I describe myself as a disability advocate. I'd hate anyone to think I'm a lawyer, especially lawyers.
What is your response, disability advocate, to the announcement made by the government yesterday?
Look, I would describe us at landing at base camp on the Hill of Hope, basically. And no one wants to be at base camp. The fact of the matter is, look, it sounds good, but my concern is it's going to give a lot of people a lot of false hope. There are 430,000 people in New Zealand who identify as carers. Now, as most people, if they just listen superficially to what was said yesterday, they'll be signing themselves up for a full-time paid job as a carer, and that simply isn't going to happen. 6 years ago, they identified 1,600 families with children like Shane, and yet only 450 have signed up to date. And that is because the process is so demeaning and so dehumanising that families just won't buy into it. Diane, since our historic victory of last year, has received nothing. We have, they offered 40 hours, but Diane refused it because in the 18 months since then, the Ministry of Health have changed nothing. And I don't care, with all due respect to the Prime Minister and to her ministers, them standing up and saying that things are changing, et cetera, et cetera. Nothing has changed in the last 18 months. The Justice Minister, Andrew Google, has Andrew Little, has been going on about Google not complying with the decisions of the court or the orders of the court. Well, the Minister of Health hasn't been complying with the decision of the court from 18 months ago. So, in the end, because of the absolute lack of response, we have taken this matter to the Employment Court. And as Diane probably says, our lawyer will speak to those issues. But, so nothing has changed for us since we saw you 18 months ago, John, and we're back.
Diane, I want to bring you in here. If people are a bit bewildered by Jane's response and the force of her expression of it, let's talk about some of the things you've been required to do. The Ministry of Health, for example, when they were determining you deserve 17 hours pay a week for looking after Shane, calculated how long you spent each day wiping his bottom. That's been part of the equation of your life, hasn't it?
Yes. I think people just don't understand what they have to go through with these demeaning, revolting assessments. To be timed to go to the toilet. How many toilet breaks are allowed a day? To cook a meal, to make a bed. I mean, give us a break. Mm. For 52 years I've been toileting him, But to get down to the minute, you're allowed so many a day. I mean,
Diane, when we first met, there was a sense that you were taken for granted in a way that was high-handed and cavalier. Yesterday, there was a really major acknowledgement of the work you do, the probability of a pay increase, potentially up to $25 an hour from the minimum wage. Things are improving. Do you feel good about what was announced yesterday?
When all the I's are dotted and the T's are crossed and it's all, done properly, then it'll be good. But let's not hold our breath just yet.
OK. And, Jane, one final question for you, disability advocate. What is it you most want to see from the government? What is the one thing that will make you sit back and sigh with delight?
I want the government to stop listening to the Ministry of Health personnel and their small cohort of so-called disability advocates. I want them to start listening to the coalface, the Dianes of this world, and frankly, the me's of this world, because I do understand the last 35-year history of this matter, but no one. We get no acknowledgement from anybody. Prime Minister hasn't responded to my correspondence. So I want them to start listening to people who know what they're talking about.
Jane Carrigan and Diane Moody, thanks so much. We heard a bit of Shane in the background too. He was starting to join in as your employer there, Diane. And
Shane's
out watching the ferries go past. So, it's pretty hard work that he's got.
It's non-stop.
Non-stop.
Thanks for joining us, you two, and congratulations on everything you've achieved so far, even though you are telling us there is still a way to go. Diane Moody and Jane Carrigan joining us from Diane's home, where she looks after Shane 24/7.
Thanks, John.